Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, still looking around Candlekeep, about to enter the barracks.
Such menial tasks.
Indeed. Fuller. Fuller than what? Not sure if he'll like me going into this stuff.
Such menial tasks.
Watcher. Sorry, young one, but you're not allowed in here. Now, go run along and do something useful. What about Fuller?
I should have joined the army.
Ugh, what a mead-filled night. That hole is just too much. Poor Sap had to go man the gate this morning, too. I don't know how he does it. What can I do for you, anyways? I was just wondering if you had any errands I could run. Errands? Yeah, actually. I need a quarrel of crossbow bolts. If you get some off Winthrop at the inn, I'll reimburse you. Oh, very well. There'll be a few coins in it for you, too, so you can stop giving me that look.
I should have joined the army.
What? No bolts? Why they let Grian bring kids like you into this place, I'll never know. I don't think I can get into this stuff here. Doesn't it F5? Autosave? Or quick save, rather. Quick save here is Q. Oh, it didn't. Press a key. Huh, it won't let me. It won't let me make it F5. Do I have something else? Key to F5? You can really hotkey anything, huh? I just have to remember that. Q! I cannot save at this time. No. Really? I just can't save in here?
Such menial tasks.
Strange.
Such menial tasks.
Hull's longsword and an antidote. Huh. Maybe he was far enough away? They're not gonna just let me get away with this, aren't they? Are they? Is it A for attack? No. I guess you're just not really not paying attention. Alright, well, I've got whole sword.
Menial tasks. A simple matter.
So one of them was talking about someone named Hull. Birdie. Hull's longsword. So it's just telling me general information in general about long swords? These swords are usually referred to as double-edged swords, war swords, or military swords. In many cases, the long sword has a single-edged blade. There is no single version of the long sword. The design and length vary from culture to culture and may vary within the same culture depending on the era. Among the most common characteristics of all long swords is their length, which ranges from 35 inches to 47 inches. In the latter case, the blade is known to take up 40 inches of the total length. Most long swords have a double-edged blade and a sharp point at the tip. Despite the tip, the long sword is designed for slashing, not thrusting. Mm-hmm. And this dagger, I guess, is... Typical dagger has a pointed, usually double-edged blade as opposed to a knife, which has a single edge and is a bit shorter. Just tell me about a necklace. A necklace is a piece of ornamental metal jewelry, usually made of silver, such as in this case, gold, platinum, or other precious metal and adorned with gems. A necklace is always worn on the neck and can be of any length. Indeed. Slings have existed since the beginning of recorded history. The basic sling consists of a leather or fabric strap with a pouch for holding the missile. The weapon is held by both ends of the strap and twirled around the wielder's head. When top speed is attained, the missile is launched by reaching one of the strap's ends. And I got an antidote. As the name implies, this potion will neutralize any poison of which the inhibitor is currently suffering the effects. The cleansing is instant, and the potion may only be used once. Cures poison. Sweet.
Such menial tasks.
Alright, so we're gonna run back to Candlekeep then to get T1's crossbow bolts, right? Fuller is recovering from last night's mead fest in the barracks. After a little pestering, he agreed to give me a little bit of change if I fetch crossbow bolts from the innkeeper, Winthrop. Alright, we'll do that. Might as well. We could use all the money we can get. If Sapphire wants to bring some books with her, we do also need some sling stones to go with the sling we bought.
A simple matter.
My hotel's as clean as an elven arse.
If you say so, Winthrop. Now he did say... Making double sure here. Crossbow bolts. I guess just one stack of crossbow bolts, however he's selling them.
My hotel's as clean as an elven arse.
This is stolen, so that's probably why it shows up red there. Or maybe it's red because I can't use it. I'm surprised he's selling something like a wakizashi, if I'm saying that right. Bolts!
Fine.
Making my way back to the barracks.
I should have joined the army.
Here you are, you little money grubber. Put a few gold pieces in your purse. Fuller gave me a lousy 10 gold for running his errands. Well, that quits out of it. Our first completed quest. I bet I'd get at least 15 for being an errand runner in Baldur's Gate. I really may want to be running errands in Baldur's Gate.
I should have joined the army.
That hull is just too much. Poor Sapphire to go man the gate this morning. What can I do for you? I don't know how he does it. Yeah, well, don't think this headache means I'm not keeping my eye on you. I already stole a whole sword. Should I increase the text? I did increase the voices a little bit. Might increase them even more. That wouldn't be under graphics, I don't think. Where did I find that? Gameplay. I don't think it would be under sounds. Feedback. To hit rolls. Do we want this? See attacking two hit rolls in a dialogue window. Sure. State changes. Character state, yeah. Miscellaneous, okay. I'm not sure. There's a quick save here. I don't know, the font size might be out in the main menu.
Such menial tasks.
The bunkhouse. Now we've been in that barrel. Like we're down on the southern end. There's another barrel. A lot of people just tend to just throw gold in here. Oh, that one's empty. What was this tutor have to say?
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
Thieving. No, we're not going to do much of that. Swear, not a thief. Detect traps button. See how it changes like that? I want it to stay bigger. I like this size, not that size. Setting traps. Any attack made while hidden also receives a +4 bonus to attack and damage. Hidden doors and illusions. I actually didn't know detect illusion was a thief ability. Makes sense though. Cheeky! What are you telling me, Cheeky? Looks like he's ready to fight me too. What's this? 15 gold. All right, bunkhouse.
I have a blade with your name on it.
What happened? Carbos. Hey there. You're Grind's little whelp, aren't you? Well, you match the description. You don't look so dangerous to me. That I am. Do I know you? No, I don't believe you do. I'll not be here long, so it don't matter. You'll not be here long either, so it matters even less. Just thought I'd have a look at you. Pretty face, but I don't see what the fuss is about. No matter. I'll deliver your skull and I'm set for life. Alright. Have at thee. Oh, so we got... Yeah, I don't know. Do I want that over the characters' heads? I could use a spell, but is it worth it? We're missing a lot. Plus, he might interrupt me. This is comical. Ouch. Damn. Wow, that hurt. Two out of six hit points, wow.
Such menial tasks.
Just a regular dagger was all he carried. Wow. What we got over here? Empty. Well, that hurt. Nothing about this? Someone wishes me dead. Grind is right to think we are no longer safe here, though I have no idea why someone would want to cause
us harm.
Something
on your mind?
I'll read that in a minute. Faerûn says, I heard shouting, Sapphire. Are you alright? He's dead. Whoever he was, he lunged at me with a knife. Oh, Faerûn, what is happening to this place? It's not this place, child. It's you they're after. Grind is waiting on the steps of the central library and wants you to go to him as soon as you have bought what you need at the inn. Oh, Sapphire, I have been your tutor for so many years, and only in this moment have I come to doubt that my teachings have been enough. Go to Garion, child. It is safe for here. It is safe for you here no longer. And just like that, he's gone.
Such menial tasks.
Garion is right to think we are no longer safe here, though I have no idea why someone would want to cause us harm. The attempt on my life may have been laughable, but I fear there will be more threats to come. Indeed. That kinda hurt. I talked to him, didn't I?
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
This is what he thought was cheeky. If I change my mind, I may steal a moment from you later. As ridiculous as it seems, I think we need to regain some hit points. Could you imagine if I did just have the base 4 hit points? Without my bonuses for constitution, my plus 2 hit point per level bonus, I'd be dead. Who's this? Oh, that's Linda?
Fine.
It is, isn't it? Yeah.
My hotel's as clean as an elven arse.
While an adequate place to rest, rooms of this type, peasant, offer little more than a roof over one's head. Recuperative benefits will likely be minimal. You get what you pay for. Its cost is 1. Merchant, a favorite of the frugal business traveler, rooms of this type are basic but comfortable. A good solid mattress and clean linen for when one must awaken presentable, but not so pampered as to promote oversleeping. Noble, these rooms are of excellent quality at a somewhat reasonable price, and a definite luxury for those accustomed to sleeping under an open sky. None but the most pampered dandy would have complaints with these accommodations. I wonder how many hit points you get back, what the difference is. A truly luxurious experience at an equally exorbitant price. Beds filled with the softest down, draped with the finest Kalimshan silks and linens, nearly as restful as a wreck in a lesser room, though who but royalty could afford the cost. It's actually not that expensive. I want as many hit points back as possible. These don't stack. I guess that makes me special daggers. Well, I can sell the daggers. Although, should I keep one and... Well, as a backup, I have the quarterstaff. Yeah, sell the daggers. I wonder if this should be identified. I doubt it's anything, but... See how much we get back. Although Gorion's not going to be happy with me. Rested for 8 hours. I am full. Good.
Fine.
We needed a rest. I don't want to undertake this journey with 2 hit points. This doesn't seem like a good idea to me. There's another tutor.
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
Why is this guy running over to me? I was informed you might be needing instructions on how to properly bend the universe here, Will. Is there anything I can tell you about the casting of spells? Well, we know everything. Let me just see what he says. Mages and bards memorize spells by selecting the mage spellbook icon on the left side of the screen. Clerics, druids, and paladins, otherwise rangers from the priest scroll icon. I'm so glad I'm playing this, guys. Gotta say it. This is gonna be really awesome. It's slow going, but awesome. Need to rest after memorizing. Got it. Okay. Sorcerers and shamans can cast any spell they know if they have spell slots of that spell's level available. Mages learn spells by copying them from spell scrolls. In your inventory, unknown spells appear with a green shaded overlay on the scroll's icon. Access the scroll's description from the inventory screen, select the right magic button, and if your attempt is successful... I think with core magic I might not be on... I'm not failing on this guy, so I will be save scumming for writing magic. I'm not sure, I think core rules, there's a which is the difficulty I'm playing at. There's a chance for failure. I think that's determined by your intelligence? I'm not sure. But my intelligence is 18, so, but I don't want to fail. That's in my opinion, that rule is BS. The scroll is consumed in the process. If you fail, you need another scroll before trying again. Yeah, not doing that. I'll learn more casting spells than being lectured about them. You say that now, but when you find yourself in a dark forest surrounded by displacer beasts and can't use your spellbook's contents, I do hope you'll remember this conversation. Return to me if you change your mind. Believe me, I've read more than quite a few books on the process of casting spells. Your advice is not needed. Now, what's this guy want? Gate Warden. Soon be gone, will you? Aye, Garion asked me to teach you a whit about the finer arts of mass combat before you leave. Can I pick your interest with it, Sapphire? Yes, Gate Warden, I would appreciate that. Good then, child. 'Tis one thing to maintain control of yourself in the heat of battle, but 'tis quite another to maintain one's authority over a group. I've arsed Ob, the illusionist, to run through a few simulations for you down in the storage cellars. Just follow me this way and I'll lock the door for you. All right. I wasn't planning on that, but okay.
Our rules are very strict.
There you be, Sapphire. If you haven't trained with Ob yet, then the door's wide open, and all you need to do is to march in. You've already done your training, then you should go and see Garion. Your father is anxious to see you. Okay. And there he is. Sapphire, the Gate Warden, arsed me to prepare a little going-away party for you. A bit of mass combat practice is in order, I believe. Well, I'll make it real simple for you. Candorus, Mordine, Arcanus, Dater, and Osprey are all going to join your party. You'll have complete control over them, same as you will with anyone else who might join you in your coming travels. Mordine sounds familiar. Once they've all joined your party, I'm going to summon in several illusions of common monsters you might encounter outside the safety of this keep. These illusions will attack the party, and it'll be up to you to issue the necessary orders to dispose of them. Oh, boy. Remember, these creatures are illusions, and they won't be able to hurt you. Try your best to kill them, however, because in the real world, pain, harm, and even death are far more real. Some of your comrades will have magic items such as potions and wands. You'll have to equip these in the quick slots of the characters who have them. Some of them also have spells. You can cast these during the battle. Remember, even rogues and warriors can benefit from a good understanding of these more arcane forms of combat. Yeah, I'm going to be a little rusty here, guys. Every so often I will ask you if you've had enough. If you have, then I shall teleport you back outside. If you wish to continue practicing, however, then I shall create some more illusions for you to fight. Are you ready, then? Good. Here we go. Enemy sighted. What is this? A gibberling. Alright, so these are my party members then. Arcanus. That's his quick weapon. I love this theme, by the way. Candorus. That's Candorus. Osprey. Wand of the Heavens. Sweet. Wrong item type. Quick items again. What is this? This wand will cause a pillar of flame to shoot out of the sky and strike the chosen target. The flames will do 8d6 damage to the target. Wow. A little overpowered for this level. With ones taken as twos, unless the target makes a save versus wand, in which case she will take half. The wand only has a certain amount of charges and will be destroyed when they are used. Flame strike. So this has three charges on... I take it, unless we have three wands. Not culture. Mordane has a bunch of stuff. Wand of Magic Missiles. When activated, the wand will eject a missile of magical energy that darts forth and unerringly strikes its target. This includes enemy creatures in a melee. The target creature must be seen or otherwise detected to be hit, however so near total concealment, such as that offered by arrow slits, can render the spell ineffective. The missile will inflict 1d4 plus 1 points of damage. Wizard Slayer. Alright, quick items, and what are these? Darts? Can I just throw darts? And here's Dater. He's got an oil of speed. Increases the movement and combat capabilities of the imbiber by 100%. Thus, a movement rate of 9 becomes 18. A character normally able to attack once in a round attacks twice. However, this does not reduce spellcasting time. The duration of the effect is 1 hour. And Potion of Healing. When wholly consumed, this potion restores 9 hit points to the person. This effect is instantaneous, and the potion is destroyed in the process. Can I put this on the quick items now? Alright, I've done what he wanted. Alright, so I should put this under quick items. My antidote. I can put that under quick weapons, although I don't have bolts yet. Alright, so
what?
Gibberlings. Or gibberlings. Can I loot stuff while they work at this?
A simple matter.
There's nothing in there. I don't think I'm gonna be able to force that.
Yes. Such menial tasks.
While they're fighting, I'm just trying to loot stuff. Have you had enough yet? If you're ready to go, I'll teleport you back outside. Otherwise, you better be ready for some more fighting. Bring on some more monsters. I'm not ready to quit yet. Good. Then I will create some more illusory monsters. This time, I'll create some Zvarts. I think that's pronounced like that. Zvarts are primarily mountain-dwelling creatures, but they can often be found on the coastline. Here we go, the Zvarts.
Yes, friend?
Watch this.
What is it?
Who's this? This is Ob.
Hello.
Hello. Wand of Magic Missiles.
Hey.
Hello. Yes, friend.
That must be charges then, because we've got two now on the Wand of... Was it Wand of the Heavens?
Hello there.
I need a sword or some strong dwarven thing.
How about switch to your axe then?
What?
I need a sword or some strong dwarven thing.
All missing. Jibs. Alright, I think I've had enough. Just take me outside. Okay then, once I teleport you outside, you're not going to be able to get back in here again. This is for your own protection, as illusions I use can sometimes be dangerous. You said they can't hurt me. It's interesting though. Alright, anything else here? This tutor here.
A simple matter.
Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
I was asked to help you with your journal. If you need help, that is. Quest entries. Once again, guys, I'm not going to read all this. This is stuff I've showed you already anyway. Notes are valuable tools. You can add your own journal entries from the journal screen by selecting Add Entry. Add or edit others as you like. You can delete an entry by selecting Edit Entry and removing the text. I want to look at that. What do I want to do if I want to keep a note for later but don't want to keep it in my backpack? Selecting Copy Note on the Letters Description screen. Notes copied this way are stored among your journal entries. That's sweet. Add, okay. So you can add an entry here. Cool. Like that. The inner grounds. Not going there yet. Oh, there's Hull. I have his sword. I stole it. Hey, kid. I woke late this morning and left my sword in the barracks before going on duty. If you want to get it for me, it's in the chest at the foot of my bed on the right side of the barracks. Quick now, before the gate warden catches me without it. You'll also find an antidote there. I think Drepin needs one for old Nessa. I want that antidote. Well, maybe I'll get more money just completing this. Hull, one of the ever-present watchers here in Candlekeep, forgot his sword in the barracks this morning. He has asked me to fetch the weapon from its resting place in its chest against the right wall. I've already done so, though not so much in a honest way. Okay, I have not left, and he tells me, took your sweet time, didn't you? Grind's a fool for trying to bring you up right, and can tell him I said so, too. If I didn't know already, I'd say this whole iron crisis is the result of twerps like you wandering off with people's swords. Here's 10 gold pieces. Now get out of here. I'm on duty. Oh my god. What an idiot. Hull gave me 10 gold pieces for bringing him his own dumb sword. I should have charged him extra the tongue lash he gave me, though. Shh. Kid, I'm on duty. Alright. This is quite a longer episode. Trying to finish up Candlekeep, but it's taking quite a while because, well, I have to explore everything and read everything. You know how it goes. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.